Now we're going to move into performing the major portions of Ghatam. Ghatam was composed in about 1995, recorded in 96 on the audiophile label MA Recordings. And all of the instruments, these ceramic pots, bowls, udu drums, ghatams, these tubes, all of these were inspired by other world music traditions for the most part. And we collaborated with the sculptor Stephen Freedman, who's currently based in Hawaii but was living in Los Angeles at the time. And we told him the sort of things we wanted, and then he would throw the pots. Everything is made by hand. Even this large vessel here was hand thrown on a wheel, and that is not even close to the largest pot that Stephen Freedman has been able to manipulate, with just clay on a wheel, good old fashioned pot throwing technique. Most of the instruments are porcelain. These are stoneware, I believe, and nothing is glazed or coated in any way. It's all just plain, clean ceramic. And just a little bit about the instruments that are traditional. These are a traditional shape. These are ghatams, which are South Indian, Carnatic, and they're used in traditional music, but the way we play them is not traditional, and you could not play traditional Indian music on these ghatams because they're made of porcelain, they're way too heavy, they don't ring in the same way that terracotta or a low-fire clay would, but that's not what we were intending to do, so we're using them mostly for their shape and their sort of inspiration and the kind of mascot for the piece. The piece is called Ghatam, and those are ghatams. M.B. is going to start by playing a solo on the udu drums, and these are from southern Nigeria. The women play them when they go down to the river to gather water. They use their water jugs to play rhythmic music on. This is a good old-fashioned vase for extremely huge flowers. These bowls here are not tuned to a particular scale, although there are different sizes, so they accidentally make some kind of a scale, and that's called jalterang. And you find the jalterang, or a set of tuned rice bowls, in various oriental cultures, such as Hindustani music and also in Japanese music. This is a C. Freedman invention, and it's basically just three pots stuck together so that the different resonating chambers will allow us to produce different tones. We have 24 tubes arranged, again, in a scale. None of these are tuned to specific pitches. We just take what, you know, what we get. But various cultures use tubes of different kinds. I believe in Papua New Guinea, they have tubes that they stamp on the ground and they make a tone. And also in certain Vietnamese traditional folk music, they have an instrument called clong phut, which is bamboo tubes. And they clap their hands in front of the opening of the tube. And by just exciting the air in front of the tube, you hear the tubes going ooh, 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 and making a tone. So much of what we're playing is inspired by world music, but it's all original music of our own, sort of filtered through the sensibility of other world cultures that we politely borrow from. Ghatam, in its original staging, involves a lot more theater and pouring of water and all kinds of transitional elements that are not very practical for us to do here tonight. So we're going to be playing four major sections, starting with MB's solo on the udu drums into a piece that, called Marvin's Udu Voodoo. We'll go into jalterang, which I get the solo on a little bit. And we'll go into Watch Your Mouth, which is Bob Fernandez's featured solo on the tubes. And then the final section is called Dong's Other Garbo. And it's a written out piece with no solos, but it relates rhythmically to the gong piece that you just heard. So hopefully there will be a little kind of bookend closure there. And this will take about 40 minutes or so for us to play, and it's uninterrupted, so once we start, if you hold your applause, even if it sounds like we've stopped, you'll know when we stopped. We'll let you know. Thank you.
Thank you.